A very good morning. It's an absolute pleasure to have all of you with us today at the conference on diversity and inclusion. Can India maximize corporate power from diverse workforce? We are grateful to His Highness Dr. Karan Singh, who has bestowed us with the honor of having him as today's chief guest. Thank you, sir. I request Dr. A.M. Sherry, Director, IMT, Center for Distance Learning, to please present a welcome bouquet to our honorable chief guest. Gracing the occasion also is Dr. Armin Brook, CEO of Siemens. Okay, he will be joining. We welcome Professor R.K. Shevgaonkar, Director, IIT Delhi, and express our gratitude for gracing the occasion. I'll request Dr. Sherry, please honor him with a bouquet. A thundering applause. We also express our heartfelt thanks to Dr. A.M. Sherry and request Dr. Deepak Dogra, our conference director, to honor him with a bouquet. May I please request Honorable Chief Guest, Dr. Karan Singh, to light the ceremonial lamp and mark the occasion open. Sir R.K. Shevgaonkar to join us in lighting the lamp. Burning, we have to keep adding oil to it. In the current context, this lamp signifies our conquest to excel and the oil signifies our learning spirit. This book is authored and edited by Dr. Deepak Dogra. Dr. A.M. Sherry for a welcome note. Dr. Arun Mohan Sherry, Director of IMTCDL, is a gold medalist, M.Tech, IIT Kharagpur. He is a recipient of Anand Swarup Bhatnagar Gold Medal, Brilliant Student Honor, Rabindranath Tagore Samman 2011. He has participated in various training programs organized by IIMs and IITs. His specialization is in the field of computer networks, inter-network technologies, and wireless communication. He has more than 19 years of work experience in teaching and research. His articles and interviews have been published in leading national newspapers like Times of India, Economic Times, HD, to name a few. Basically, Dr. Sherry has introduced the concept of industry-university partnership to produce skilled manpower as per the need of the industries.
Good morning. Honorable Dr. Karan Singh, Member of Parliament, Rajya Sabha. Dr. R.K. Shimgaonkar, Director, IIT Delhi. CEOs, professors, executives, delegates, guests, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of IMT CGL Ghaziabad, I am very pleased to welcome you all to the conference Diversity and Inclusion. Can India maximize corporate power from diverse workforce? I know that many of you have also traveled from quite a distance to participate in this conference we have ever had before. I thank for this gesture too. IMT was established in 1980 at Ghaziabad. Now we have one campus at Hyderabad, one at Nagpur, one at Dubai. And our distance learning division, we have 60 study centers across the country. As far as the positioning of IMT is concerned, IMT from last 31 years, we are among top 10 B schools of the country. And our distance learning division is number one in the country as per the recent surveys conducted by various media. The new knowledge-based society demands managers who are flexible and versatile. They need to learn continuously and upgrade their skill as the technology advances. Fully alive to the emerging challenges, IMT CGL has been in the forefront, establishing a lead through preparing managers of tomorrow with distinct vision blended with technology and skills. In B school curriculum, all over the globe, typically diversity management seems to feature either as a part of certain course or module or standalone elective class. Furthermore, specific sub areas of diversity, for example, culture, nationality, gender, etc., receive considerably more faculty attention than others. One could therefore question to what extent diversity management is being taught as a holistic concept in business schools. Having today conference strengthens our belief for need of course in diversity and inclusion. Globally, the original model for diversity was situated around affirmative action, drawing strength from the law and the need to comply with equal employment opportunity objectives. This compliance-based model gave rise to the idea that of tokenism. Then social justice model evolved next and extended the idea that individuals outside of the dominant group should be given opportunities within the workplace. When it comes to India, Indian organizations by and large have contained diversity and have not used for integration. I hope that this conference will aim to understand integration part of the diversity and inclusion, having emphasis on Indian perspective. In short, when we debate, can India maximize corporate power from diverse workforce, we will have deliberations to know views on these issues from the corporate, academia, and expert throughout the day. This conference definitely a step forward to understand the Indian aspect of diversity and inclusion. I am sure this is not the end, but a beginning towards developing research-based knowledge capital for the Indian corporate. Thank you.
I would be cordially inviting Honorable Dr. Karan Singh to kindly highlight the many dimensions of management. His Highness Dr. Karan Singh, MP Rajya Sabha, President ICCR, born into the ruling family of Jammu and Kashmir, always had a passion for education and has written on various aspects of education. He is a member of UNESCO International Commission on Education for the 21st century. He firmly believes that education has a deep impact on physical, aesthetic, intellectual dimensions of people. He is an avid reader and has authored innumerable books and essays. Born as the only son of Maharaja Hari Singh, he joined politics at the age of 18 years. He moved to federal politics and has served as a minister several times. At the age of 36, he was the youngest cabinet minister of tourism and civil aviation. Dr. Karan Singh was awarded the Padma Vibhushan in January 2005. At present, he has been appointed chairman of the Foreign Affairs Cell of the Congress Party. Apart from this hectic schedule, his love for music rejuvenates and refreshes him. His Highness learned Indian classical music and practices it till date. It might come as a surprise to many of you. He is a rock and roll addict. Dr. Karan Singh's words, 50 years of independence and India going through a period of tremendous turbulence. The old consensus has broken down and a new equilibrium has not yet emerged. At the same time, global society beckons on the horizon and we really need to understand and act. With a standing ovation, let's honor His Highness Dr. Karan Singh with a thundering applause.
Dr. Deepak Dogra, distinguished members in the audience and young friends. The title of your conference is rather forbidding. I've been trying to figure it out for the last week or two, again, I still haven't succeeded in understanding what it exactly means. However, therefore, I thought what I would do is to just mention a few general dimensions of management, which may not be taught in management schools, but which are very important for the development of the nation. Because we are today facing a very difficult situation politically, economically, and socially, and therefore management techniques need to be introduced at all levels if we are to maximize our strengths and minimize our weaknesses. First of all, let's talk about managing the political system. Very often you find that parliament is becoming dysfunctional. The sessions are disrupted, the number of days the parliament sits are very few, and the whole parliamentary system seems to be under great pressure. Before that, the electoral system needs to be managed. And in elections, as you know, that is where really the trouble starts. Because our elections have become so expensive now. Even to get a ticket, I believe, you've got to pay a crore of rupees, far less to fight an election. Where is that money going to come from? And if that money comes from so-called black money, then it will multiply. So unless at the source of the whole electoral process, we are able to have a different management program, we will never get out of this double bind. I have certain ideas regarding electoral reform. It's a very long subject, I won't get into it. One of them, for example, is there should be compulsory voting. I see no reason why those people who enjoy the benefits of democracy should not have to vote once a year or once in 5 years. You can't have the benefits and not make your contribution. There's no big deal. Australia has voting, which is universal, and therefore voting becoming compulsory, I would say, is a very important factor, because then you would get a better idea of what the people really want. At present, there's 50% voting, out of which there may be 10 candidates,